The basic camera is composed of a lightproof box with a lens on one side and an imaging device or target on the other. In the past, the target would have been film, but these days the target is usually a light-sensitive computer chip called a charge-coupled device, or CCD for short. Add to this a variable speed shutter and the means to view and record the image that has been formed on the target, then you pretty much have a perfect description of a stills camera. What distinguishes the video camera from a stills camera is that it can record a stream of images at constant speed, creating the illusion of live action movement. This stream of images is commonly called the frame rate. In the evolution of television, several frame rates have evolved. In the USA and countries that use the NTSC system, a frame rate of 30 frames per second is the standard. And in Europe and countries where PAL and CCAM is the video format, a frame rate of 25 frames per second is employed. Each video image is made up of pixels. The more pixels, the better the screen resolution, which translates image-wise into better detail and better contrast. For example, NTSC has a total of 525 horizontal scan lines, but only 480 of these are used for the actual image. There are 720 elongated pixels in each interlaced scan line. So, by multiplying one by the other, we find that an NTSC picture contains nearly 350,000 pixels. By comparison, a PAL image made up of 576 horizontal scan lines, 720 elongated pixels wide, contains just under 415,000 pixels. Now, compare this with high-definition television, with its smaller, squarer pixels, 1,080 pixels high by 1,920 pixels wide, and the figure per frame equates to over 2 million pixels, or, to put it another way, that's 2 megapixels per image. Now, that's 5 times better resolution than a PAL frame, and 6 times better resolution than an NTSC frame. Distinct from the frame rate is the shutter speed. For NTSC, the standard shutter speed is 1/60th of a second, and for PAL it's 1/50th of a second. Control over shutter speed gives the user the opportunity to blur or blend images if the speed is set slower than the standard setting, or if the aim is to freeze detail, then just as with a stills camera, a fast shutter speed can be selected. A good example of this would be in a sports program where faster shutter speeds enable detail of fast-moving objects, such as a soccer ball, to be clearly visible, especially when replayed in slow motion. It's worth noting that, unlike stills cameras, which generally use only one imaging target, many professional video cameras use a prism to split the image into the three primary colors used to create the television picture: red, blue and green. A cleaner, higher resolution, lower contrast image is produced by keeping the colors separate. Now, before the advent of large capacity flash memory cards, videotape has traditionally been used as the recording medium for video images. The magnetically coated tape, housed in a protective cassette, is progressively magnetized as it passes a revolving video head. There is so much data inherent in a widescreen color video data stream that the general accepted rule by the manufacturers is that the more data that's recorded, the better the quality of the video and the audio reproduction. Over time, manufacturers have brought many systems to the market, most of which feature varying degrees of compression. Compression generally means getting more information onto the video recording medium at the cost of some image quality. Yet we have seen that the more information that's recorded, the better the image detail and contrast. Consider that the highest quality data rate of a professional HDCam SR camera operates at 600 megabits per second. Yet for small camera formats, such as we're discussing in this video, data rates of just 25 megabits per second produce acceptable broadcast video for most applications. So, for the small camera formats using PAL and NTSC standards, DVCam and DVC Pro recorded onto mini DV tapes are the most common formats. And as the world moves towards high definition, formats such as HDV, which still uses the same mini DV cassettes, and AVCHD, which records directly to a custom memory stick, are used for the cost-effective recording of high-definition video. And many cameras that use memory cards to record the video stream have the ability to record at slow frame rates, which yield speeded up action, or fast frame rates, which will yield slow motion video when played back at the standard video frame rate. Such effects were previously only possible using variable speed videotape cameras. The use of memory cards as the recording medium brings affordable, variable speed recording within the reach of everyone, with the added bonus that, when a memory card is plugged into an edit suite, the images are instantly available for use, whereas with tape, the video needs to be transferred to the suite's hard disks in real time from a playback deck before anything can be edited, which is a time-consuming process. Some hybrid cameras offer simultaneous tape and memory recording. The advantage here is that the videographer gains instant and durable tape archive backup, as well as instant access to content at edit via the memory card.